Hello, hello, hello. Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of The Hive. Yes. I'm your boy, Sexy Shay, ThaWidow. And of course, we have the lovely, as always, you know her, you love her, Miss Georgia Peach.
Oh, my God.
Is Nata. You know how
every time, O'Shea, you wow me every single time. What's up, everybody? Welcome to yet another episode of The Hive. What are we talking about today, O'Shea?
So, as y'all know, CW just released a new trailer for Superman Lois. You all know this is part of the Arrowverse. For all those who've been watching it or haven't been watching it, so after the Crisis of Infinite Earths crossover they did, this is all the Earths combined. It's now Earth Prime. So Superman with Tyler Hoechlin, I think.
Yeah,
is her name. His name. His Superman. They're doing a spinoff series for his Superman and Lois. And him and Lois have two kids, two sons. So it's not just one Superboy, two Superboys. And
are they both superpowered though? Do we know that much about them?
Yeah. They'll both have powers. Each of them, of course, I think, of course, the show will start to manifest at various stages of their lives. And of course, obviously, it's up to Clark and Lois to kind of help them.
Guide them along the way.
Right. And control them. Control their powers. While, of course, also being the world's savior. On top of that, dealing with any new villains and whatnot. Also, it occurred to me that people that this TV series had a budget like those films for HBO Max. So it's made look
better than normal CW shows, everybody, because CW shows are booty. And yeah. This is from a former CW fan. Like I was here for the Arrowverse show for a while, and then it got a little too campy for my liking. And that is my fear, but we can get to all that after we watch this trailer.
Yep.
Because that is why the people are here to see this trailer.
So give
it up.
And for anyone who's wondering or already asking in the comment section what's up with my get up, like I said, I just worked out and my hair is all freaked up. So you guys are gonna get the beanie Sexy Chain tonight, but it's tonight here. So I'm gonna say for this episode of The Hive.
He's always sexy though, y'all. Whether he got a beanie on or whether he's in the bathtub or whatever we got.
Speaking of that, go everyone. If you haven't yet, go check out After Dark Times with The Hive. You'll love it. It's killer. Exclusive content. So why wait for Nata to cue the trailer? She has it up. Perfect. All right. Let's go. Let's get it.
Of course, I screwed it up. Please hold. Let me try this one more time.
We're having technical difficulties. Hello, everyone in the chat. Hello, hello. I hope you guys' day and night are going well.
When we were dreaming about having a family, it didn't look like this, did it? Lost jobs. Teens with severe anxiety. Parents coming too soon.
Why'd you move the family here? Still looking for the simple life? Because those days are gone, Clark. Long gone.
You got the weight of the world on your shoulders.
Really wish I could get drunk sometimes. You're saying you're Superman? No, we've seen Superman before. We've seen him.
Am I a bad father?
We're gonna be all right. No one ever dreams about the problems, but every life has them. Even the extraordinary ones.
Superman and Lois, 2-hour premiere event, Tuesday, February 23rd. Stream free next day, only on the CW app.
Well, what are your thoughts?
I can definitely see it. It's a different feeling style, so much more different. It has a very cinematic feeling style in comparison to the Arrowverse TV shows. Like, to be honest, I think they low key throwing shade at the other shows because it's like, especially for The Flash, who has been like I'm pretty sure like their top show on there, and like they had, and I'm surprised they haven't given the same budget to that show by now. Like, but that's neither here nor there. But back to this, yeah, you know, it's I'm more interested, you know, obviously the dynamic of Clark wrestling with, of course, you know, being a father, being and also being a superhero, and also, you know, eventually revealing that to his sons that he is Superman. And of course, and then the sons probably discovering that they also are part Kryptonian and they also have power. Now, I'm more interested in if they will have the full, all of Superman's powers like their dad, or like Superboy, where he's just limited to some abilities. Like, one son would have like super strength and vulnerability, and the other one would just have like laser vision, you know, stuff like that.
Well, it obviously looks like they are in their mid-teens, obviously, at this point.
Yeah.
And he's revealing, because they don't believe him apparently in the beginning, that he's Superman. So he has to show them. So I guess their power is going to come in. I guess he keeps in tune with, well, I don't know. I'm trying to think on Smallville. His power started to develop a little bit earlier. But I guess because of half Kryptonian, it takes a little longer for it to develop, is my guess.
Yeah, it might develop like during, like, if they're really stressed. During difficult, stressful situations, that's kind of like a common thing. Some powers may manifest during if you're really stressed or in danger. You might do it like that. Anyone else in the chat?
Do you think there'll be any unfair comparisons to Lois and Clark with Dean Cain and Terry Hatcher? You think there's going to be any unfair comparisons, or is this going to be like so different that they won't be able to compare it to?
You know, I don't suspect or expect any comparisons to Lois and Clark, unless the dynamic and how things play out is almost damn near similar to the dynamic between Lois and Dean Cain's Clark.
Yeah, I think they're already going to be ahead of that because obviously she knows he's Superman. And so that whole mystery part of it is already behind them. This is like well into their relationship they established. Yeah. I did find it interesting that they named it Superman and Lois.
Mm.
As opposed to, you know, going by his Earth name.
Clark and Lois.
Yeah, or, you know, but I guess it would have been too close of a comparison.
Yeah, that'd be a little too much, because then, you're thinking that, okay, so this is like a reboot.
So I think that, you know, what that signals to me is that there's going to be more focus on the Superman aspect of him and trying to balance that with married life and all the things that come along with it.
Hold up. My thing is, I think it might be some comparison to this and Man of Steel. Especially how it looks, of course, and like we just said, struggling with the dynamic of being a father, being a superhero, all those elements that's also played upon. Man, still,
maybe we're gonna get more emo Clark. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I hope not, but you know, more so like playing on some of those aspects, but not like going over the top with it, you know, given the fact that this Superman is married to Lois and they already have. The children are already in their teens already.
Mm.
Versus that Superman, where he him and Lois just met and just fell in love.
Well, I did rewind it back just a little bit because I wanted to make sure I wasn't seeing things, and I was not. Because at initial review, when she talked about parents that died too soon, I assumed they were looking at Jonathan and Martha, right? Is my assumption. And for a split second, as it was going, I thought that it was John Schneider who played Clark's father in the Smallville series.
Oh.
That's who I thought it was initially, but upon further inspection, it's not him. So I thought that was going to be like a callback kind of like what we talked about last week, how they're going to bring people in that we're familiar with to introduce like a new iteration of a character. But that's not the case right here.
Oh, no. They already did that with the crossover. We had Tom Welling for like a few moments when you found out he gave up his powers to have a life. Yeah, that happened.
So, do you have any concerns about this going down the CW rabbit hole? Because, like, Supergirl, right? Supergirl started out on CBS, I think.
Yeah, CBS, and they moved over to CW. And then, of course, they did the multiverse thing where she was on a different Earth, and that's how they crossed over. So while we're on the subject, they did confirm, the CW producers, they confirmed that they are doing a Flash and Superman race, or episode or crossover where Flash by the comics will race Superman to see who's just the fastest. And they teased that a little bit with Supergirl and the Flash during their first crossover, but then now they want to actually do it with Flash and Superman. This Superman, Grant Gustin's Flash and Tyler Hoechlin's Superman.
Do you care?
Not really, because I mean, not really, because it's like, I'm pretty sure all those who read the comics more, did they not already establish that Flash is faster than Superman? Yeah. And we'll see
proper form with the race. How about that? Be a little different from what we've seen.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, I ain't gonna lie. I will check out the episode across it when it happens, but I'm not like, oh my God, you see that right now, you know? Like, I feel as though when it comes to anything, DC Universe, at least now, I don't know. It's like, I'll watch it, but I'm not like, oh my God, I need to see it right now. Like in the earlier season of The Flash, The Arrow, parts of Supergirl, actually, not gonna lie, the only season of Supergirl I watched and actually enjoyed the most is actually season 3, where they had the World Killers, but that's about it. After that, I kind of like stopped watching Supergirl. I'm like, well, I don't know what the fuck they're doing.
I watched season 1 all the way through, and then I said I can't do this anymore.
Okay. So,
when it moved to CW, the quality went down. Like, CBS, yeah. it was pretty good. Like, I watched the first season, I was like, oh, this is pretty good. And then whenever that transitioned to CW, it got different. The quality went down. It got super campy. It just wasn't enjoyable anymore.
I think season 3, you might enjoy a little bit more because it has a little more serious tone, which is interesting.
Like, I don't know if they could go back, though, because like they went so far
away. Well, so I'm not going to say, when I say serious, I mean not like Arrow, where they basically turn Green Arrow into Batman, which I don't understand it either, but you know. Okay. But we won't go down that rabbit hole. But no, I say, now that if you have the time, whenever you have the time, I would definitely recommend you check out Supergirl season 3. I think you might like that just as much like you did season 1. Because even season 3, they even end up the stakes. They even gave Supergirl a challenge.
Is it CGI bad? Are the effects bad? Like,
no, it's actually pretty good. Like, they don't do too much, like, you know, over the obvious CG effects, other than maybe a few episodes, but that's about it. I think you're gonna love like the main antagonist or antagonist of season 3. Like,
oh, this when Linda Carter came and or Terry Hatcher was one. I know that they've had like cameos from both of them on the show.
No, it wasn't that one. That wasn't in season 2. No, this season 3 is about Supergirl and the World Killers, where I guess the World Killers, they're basically Kryptonian, but they're from another part of Kandor, and they're Kryptonian scientists where they create these world killers to be similar like Doomsday, but not like monsters looking thing. Like, they each have various abilities that they can take on Supergirl. Like, even one of them can actually almost defeat the Kryptonians. Like, that's how powerful they become. Like, and their leader is Rain, who has similar powers to Supergirl, but she's different than Kara and Superman in that she doesn't draw her power from the sun.
Well, okay, I'll check it out. I'm not convinced. But what do we think about this Superman and Lois? We think that it's gonna, do you think it's gonna start out really high and then kind of tip down, or you think they're gonna be able to maintain this high level cinematography? Because it looks cool.
Oh yeah, like I said, it looks like a damn near like a goddamn film, ready for release on HBO Max. You know, well, before the show started, I said, well, that could be an option where after the 2-hour premiere, it looks all great and everything, and then like episode 3 or so is like, oh shit, what happened? They revert back to the scene.
Let's stay positive, right? We'll stay positive.
We'll stay positive.
At first glance, it looks really good. You know, I did not have any excitement about this when I heard about it. You know, yeah. I was kind of mad on it, but you know, seeing it, and I like the actors. I've seen them in separate, you know, projects they worked on. I saw maybe 1 or 2 episodes of the latter part of Supergirl when this Lois and Clark were on, where Lois and Superman were on there. And so they have good chemistry. So I'd be interested to check it out and see how it goes. I just don't want him to be like too moody. Like, I know it's going to, I feel like this is going to have some darkness in it somewhere, because he's struggling with trying to provide a normal life for his family, but also knowing that he is anything but normal, which means that his family is anything but normal. So there's going to be that constant struggle of that whole thing. His son, his children coming into their powers and trying to get them to understand it. It's kind of like him reliving his childhood all over again. And hopefully he'll steer them in the right direction. And they, you know, from other iterations of Clark, his childhood, and he struggled through everything.
I'm sure he will. Like, besides, he has Lois right in there, his right-hand woman right there to help him lead the way to make sure his children don't go astray. Because Lord knows what happens if, you know, one of his children goes the dark side.
It's gonna be a bright burn situation, but
right.
So what do we think about this trailer? What are we rating this on a scale of 5 lips? What are we giving it?
From the first, I'm going to give it. It piques both our interests. I'm going to give it, for me, I'm gonna say 3.95 out of 5.
Oh my god, that's specific.
Because I'm in between 3 and 4. You know, it's
that's fair. I'm just gonna go ahead and throw a 4 out there. It kind of pulled me from the land of I don't really care about this to I think I want to check it out. You know, I think I want to check it out. See where the story goes, see what version of Clark they're going to bring to us. You know, I'm very interested in that whole thing and the family dynamic. We haven't seen this on film yet. You know, we've seen a couple of different versions of Lois and Clark having a family in the comics, and that keeps getting retconned over and over and over again. So it'll be interesting to see it on film for the first time. So yeah. I'll give it a 4. Okay. I think that's respectable. February 23rd is the premiere, Be sure to check back in with O'Shea and myself, because I'm sure that we're going to give y'all the tea on what we think about this 2-hour premiere.
Yes, you will. We'll give you all the tea. Mm-hmm. And obviously our speculation, we'll probably speculate how it's going to go after that. But yeah, we'll definitely check out this 2-hour premiere. Mm-hmm. And, you know, like I said, it's funny you mentioned that's how we're getting this on TV and the film, which also goes back to another argument. We said that, why is this a thing all of a sudden? Why can't we not get like Superman as a film? And doesn't necessarily need to be a Man of Steel 2 or something.
Well, you know, with the new direction they're trying to move in with, you know, merging all the media. Right, their whole thing where, you know, it can dip in and out of all genres of media. So maybe this is just a setup for Superman on film. Maybe.
But I'm just saying though, it's like, how can you greenlit like this and be so confident and just go and just and it's here, and somehow when it comes to the live action film, it's like ideas just go out the window. It's like it can't think of anything. You're even getting a Green Lantern on HBO Max. Where's the film at?
Maybe it's safer. It's safer to try it on TV, cable chat on TV before you do that damn film. See how it's received, learn from that, and then grow on it, and then come back with the film release. How about that, O'Shea? Can we buy that?
I suppose, but you know, it's the same concept when they for all those who stuck and saw the little Easter eggs, or not Easter, but like a little credit scene when everyone watching the Crisis of Infinite Earths crossover in the Arrowverse, where John Diggle basically got the Green Lantern ring. I'm just like, wow. So where's the film at? Where the rest at? Where's the film at? Where's the rest of this? Where's the new? Hell, y'all can, since y'all doing the multiverse, you can cast another Superman.
They will.
Put him on the same Earth as Pattinson's Batman. Like, come on, and also, we didn't talk about this, but I was
going down a rabbit hole, y'all. He has
filmed. Am I there? I actually wanted to talk about this even while we had this discussion. Anyway, I was looking at some of the pictures that also released for the Batman. It's a while back, and on the set, and. One of the pictures was they're having a little Halloween costume party, and some of the people were dressed as Superman and Wonder Woman. And also, there are also newspaper articles as well that are released that mention Metropolis, and the guy and mentioned Superman Metropolis. And I was like, oh, okay, for sure. So definitely the Justice League or Justice League do exist in this world. Batman, and they are active, so I'm just like, oh, okay. So guess what, WB? Guess what? You can have multiple Superman. You got on TV here in Cabo in the Snyder Cut in this and the third. So where's the new guy at? You can have another one on a different Earth. Like,
well, maybe that's a surprise that's coming down the line, right?
I hope so, because I'm sorry, I need some type of connectivity here, where it's a universe where. It's not so divided, and that everyone can love it. It's like, I don't know. But back to
the beauty of having the ability to have Elseworlds in your stories is that you can tell 100 different tales, 100 different ways with 100 different
versions
of that character. So,
and that's the thing. It's like, oh, it's like, oh my God, who came up with the multiverse? Stop it. See, it's because
the multiverse exists in almost every comic book.
That's a damn shame.
It gives options. It gives the writers, and we can go into that. We can do a study of that on another episode of Hive about why multiverses came about and all that kind of stuff. But
I need some education on this. I'm like, but why? Why would you want to do that?
Well, it just opens up the possibilities, is what it does. It allows you to fix things because you know we're getting off track, but just a quick thing. So you know that in the comic book world. Artists change all the time. You know, the direction of the comic changes all the time. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Introducing the multiverse gives you an automatic out. Because you can say, oh, well, this was on a different Earth. This happened at a different thing. There was like a huge reset like recently. And I'm really excited about that. And we can talk about that later. But there was a huge reset in DC Comics. So we are out of New 52. We're out of, I think it was just a metal something. It was like death. It was something metal phase that DC Comics was just in. And now they just had another rebirth like event where everything got wiped out and everything started over. Mm. And you'll be very, very surprised as to who spearheaded the whole thing. Who do you think spearheaded the whole thing?
It's not Geoff Johns, is it?
No.
Walter Mother?
Wonder Woman.
Oh.
You'd be very interested. I'm going to send you a link to a video. And you'll be very interested about it. So, and we could talk about that later, and we can discuss it in great detail in the next Hive video. But we'll go ahead and wrap this up. Right. And I have given our thoughts and opinions on this trailer. We are both excited about the new show. We have high hopes for it. You know, for it to be a CW show, I hope and pray that it can bring up the CW, because this looks like a quality show. The cinematography looks good so far. you know, hopefully that doesn't come and go with the 2-hour premiere.
Right.
So we'll see how that goes. But O'Shea, any parting words before we get up out of here?
No, I think you said everything good as always. Like I said, we will be checking out, so look out for our review. Don't forget, guys, share us your comments in the comment section, your thoughts on what you thought about the trailer and your expectations of the show as in within the overarching of the Arrowverse. And any comments or your personal thoughts on about what I said when it comes to, you know, since there being multiverse, having an established Justice League in the Robert Pattinson's Batman's Earth, since the newspaper articles did confirm that a Superman Metropolis does exist in that world and he is active. So you have Henry Cavill over here in Snyderverse and Tyler Hoechlin in the Arrowverse. So what are you guys' thoughts on that? And who would you personally cast for Superman in Pattinson's world? I would love to hear your thoughts on that. But we're going to get on out of here. So I hope you guys have a safe rest of your day, evening, and or night. Mm-hmm. And we see you guys next time. I'm your boy, Sexy Shay, for The Widow. This is Ms. Nata for The Widow as well. Shout out to Ashley, Jody, and the JC family. And we're out.